Hey guys, and welcome back to my channel, Enginomics, which covers everything engineering and economics related. Today, I'm going to be talking about the Tesla Loop, this kind of experimental Las Vegas wonderland that they have underneath the Las Vegas Convention Center. So I kind of want to go into the good things that I see with this technology, the bad things with this technology as well, and provide kind of my feedback on it. And I'm going to add this to my series called Future or Farce, because I think that this would be a very interesting topic to dive into. So without further ado, let's see if this technology is futuristic or if it's just complete vaporware or farce. Part one, what is a Hyperloop? So Tesla kind of had this project a little while back where Elon Musk proposed this idyllic utopian kind of dream of this technology called the Hyperloop. And the Hyperloop kind of works like this. It's essentially a train, or as they call it, a sled, which kind of goes in a tube. And in this tube, it's actually vacuum sealed. So there's no internal air resistance for a train passing through it. It kind of makes a lot of sense from an aerodynamics perspective, but it turns out that this project is kind of expensive, and especially with all of the technology that it would take to essentially seal off an entire vacuum tube, the length of a distance that the car would be going in, it ended up being kind of expensive. And even though this has a lot of different potential, especially with the ability to go over 100 miles an hour and plus speeds like that, I'll put the exact speeds that it could achieve right here, there's a lot of kind of downsides to it and a lot of failure that could occur if this was implemented in everyday life. So in order to kind of go forward with this project, speeds would have to be reduced, and that would increase the flexibility of their tunnels. Enter these kind of experimental sled designs, which would allow for cars to drive onto them above ground. They would then be transported via an elevator to below ground on these sleds, and then the sleds would accelerate very fast speeds with no traffic and take you from point A to point B, where another elevator would take you back to the surface. If you can't tell already, this kind of idea is a little convoluted, complex, and they realized that this would be a very expensive endeavor, so they scrapped that once again in favor of their final design, which is actually in place today. So now that we've gone through this history of vaporware and weird concepts that Tesla has come up with for mass transportation, we arrive at the final design today. And that is a car going through a tunnel at around 35 miles an hour, presumably, hopefully self-driving in the future, but not right now. And I have a lot of thoughts on that. So in Las Vegas, Elon Musk made a deal with the Las Vegas government to install these tunnels around using his company, the Boring Company, and then drive self-driving Teslas through them at around 35 miles an hour. Right now, there's a strip that's actually open to the public, and that is in the Las Vegas Convention Center. It has three stops on it, and there's set queue times, there's set ride times, there's infrastructure in place to have these cars go around and pick up passengers. That said, they have plans to expand this to further abilities in the future. They actually plan on making this loop. It's not really a loop right now, it's more of a three-point line. They want to expand this loop to include the Strip, the famous Las Vegas Strip, and all of its casinos and hotels, and then also connect that back to the airport. Therefore, you wouldn't really have to rent a car or get an Uber or get a taxi in Las Vegas. You would be able to, theoretically, ride these self-driving Teslas around underground with no traffic from casino to hotel to convention center to the airport. It's kind of an actually genius idea if you think about it. With that said, that leads me to part two, the problems. So there's a lot of concerns when it comes to Tesla and their self-driving car tunnels that they're installing under Las Vegas. The first of which is economic. When it comes to economics, there's a little bit of a problem based on the fact that a lot of people think that it would just be better to install tried and true, you guessed it, just subways. Subway technology has existed for hundreds of years, and the fact that they are instead going the route of the automobile makes it kind of look like Dwight D. Eisenhower invented an underground transportation method. It's just taking the problems of traffic and the problems of cars and sticking it underground. Another economic concern, and I guess this really kind of plays into logistical concerns, is the problem when it comes to capacity. With capacity, there's only Tesla Model X's and Tesla Model 3's that are in the tunnel driving right now. And right now, they're only using three passengers per car, when that creates a lot of logistical errors when you see the design of the onboarding process, which kind of just resembles a rudimentary taxi stand. There's no real new breaking technology here, and there's a lot of logistical problems when it comes to capacity. The obvious solution to this would be increasing the capacity of the vehicles, putting buses there, basically making electric subway cars, and right now that has kind of been thrown under the rug. From a Vegas press release, the Vegas Loop only features Tesla Model X and Model 3 vehicles rather than the larger 16-person cars, with President and CEO of Las Vegas Convention and Visitors Authority Steve Hill telling the Las Vegas Review-Journal, "It seems that during a pandemic is not the time to be increasing capacity." And I think this statement is kind of mind-boggling because they blame the pandemic for not being able to increase capacity of the cars when this entire service is, one, a public transportation method, and two, it literally goes under a convention center, which I don't think they would be having conventions during a pandemic, and it connects to casinos, which are also where large amounts of people meet, and it's planned in the future to visit the airport, which is where more people are. I just don't think that this is a valid reason for not at least looking and diving into possible solutions in the future for large capacity vehicles. Another logistical problem is just the design and the onboarding and offboarding process of this loop. Tesla has promised a crazy amount of throughput with this system. I'll put the number right here, actually. And they are going to have to really bend the laws of physics and technology in order to accomplish these kinds of throughputs. This guy actually made this simulation where he simulates the entire three-point loop that is currently underway. And he basically had to crank the speeds all the way up to these cars blazing through the tunnels at around 145 miles an hour in order to actually achieve the throughput that Tesla has been promising. So I'm just kind of worried about the promises that Tesla is making to Las Vegas when it comes to public transportation, in air quotes, and hopefully they will address this in the future or maybe scale it in a way that is more sustainable, maybe adding more lanes, maybe just changing the capacity of the vehicles in general. Now that we've covered the economic and logistical concerns when it comes to this loop, let's look into the design problems that I have with this design. The first design concern with this tunnel system is just about kind of how unproven it is. And it kind of goes back to how unproven a lot of Tesla's features are and a lot of Tesla's designs are. There's a lot of problems with Tesla cars as is, let alone when you stick them in a basically 3-4 meter tube underground. So the first problem is basically just safety. When you think about it, you're sticking a car with a lot of lithium ion batteries underground, and that leads to a lot of concerns with safety. Just last week, there was a Tesla that crashed, and it took hours and gallons of water to put it out safely. And that's because these lithium ion batteries burn for a good while. Put that in a tunnel, and that becomes even more of a concern, especially when you look at the design of the tunnel, and you can basically see that it's almost impossible, I would have to see, to essentially open the doors and get out of the car if that was a problem. The other concern is just breakdowns, right? Cars are cars, and they're going to break down at some point, and I think maintenance on a lot of this would be pretty difficult unless you implemented some sort of predictive maintenance system, which again is kind of just like a headache. It's going to be interesting to see how Tesla tackles the problem of reliable rides on a thing that is just self-driving in a tunnel underground. I just don't see them being able to service this unless they kind of expand it out into more cities and more capabilities and make this actually a part of either the Boring Company or Tesla. Safety is a huge concern for me. With reliability and upkeep of this system, I really hope that Tesla creates some sort of partnership with the Las Vegas government or with the convention center to make some sort of reliable maintenance system that they come in, they fix Teslas, they offer new Teslas, they replace batteries when necessary, and they ensure that the self-driving capabilities within these cars will not fail under the given track. So here's part three. If things are so bad and unproven, then why are they doing this, and why am I kind of excited about this? Okay, with all those concerns out of the way, I actually have some things that I really like about this system and I think is really genius when it comes to Tesla's part. I'll explain those here. So for those unfamiliar, Las Vegas and the Las Vegas Convention Center host CES every year. CES is the Consumer Electronics Show, and it's a giant convention which shows off future tech, cool products, and just futuristic technology that you didn't think was possible. And for that reason alone, I think Tesla's implementation of their loop, especially under this convention center, is a genius marketing tactic. That's because CES is attracting all of this talent every year to its doors. And that means that basically these people are gonna need to get around somehow. So what better way than to basically offer a free Tesla ride underground in this futuristic setting with, they have literal gamer lights on it. It's kind of hilarious, but it's this experience center. It's this permanent installation in the Las Vegas Convention Center that will be there every year, and Tesla can modify it and change it and offer new cars and new experiences and basically put it all into this convention center that has all this attention to it every year. So I genuinely hope that this isn't just some sort of marketing ploy to basically do a quick cash grab with the Las Vegas government and then get out of town. I hope this is a permanent installation that will allow Tesla to break into the field of public transportation and also attract and basically convince skeptics of their technology. Another thing that I love about this Vegas loop is actually the price. It's super cheap. I mean, the Boring Company has been doing a great job, and it's perhaps maybe their only business model, is just making the cost of tunneling cheaper. And with this, the cost of this three-point Vegas loop system was $56 million, I believe. I'll put the actual number here. But that's incredibly cheap. It can cost billions of dollars to make a mile of subway pretty much anywhere else in the world. So the fact that they're able to basically drag and drop their own capabilities and technologies under the Las Vegas Convention Center for pennies on the dollar is just an incredible idea. And from Las Vegas and Tesla's perspective, they're not always gonna be the ones who are footing the bill for this public transportation method. Basically, Tesla could offer tunneling as a service and have businesses such as casinos, airports, or hotels essentially pay for the stops themselves and the infrastructure there, and then Tesla could just basically route a tunnel to them and add it to their network of tunnels. This could be a potentially huge game changer when it comes to public transportation, and I really want to see where this goes in the future. And finally, the last thing that I really like about this concept is that the closed corridors of these tunnels could be a great testing ground for Tesla's self-driving features. Tesla and other self-driving car companies have had a tough time gaining traction and trust within the consumer space, and especially regulation space. So by offering these closed, safe areas where self-driving cars will be able to go underground without the risk of hitting anyone or knocking over lampposts or anything or causing any crazy amount of damage, Tesla will be able to improve and prove to the government and prove to consumers that their self-driving capabilities can in fact be trusted and that they should be maybe approved for more widespread usage in self-driving. So for part four, I just want to kind of summarize both points that I threw out there. And that's basically that I think this Tesla loop idea is a horribly efficient method of public transportation. There's much better and proven ways out there. But I think that putting self-driving cars underground like this could actually really propel Tesla, increase their market space, and is a great marketing tactic for them. I think that the relationship between Vegas and Tesla, I hope that Tesla realizes that this is their kind of proving grounds for self-driving and for this system. So I really hope that they put a lot of effort into maintaining this Tesla loop and expanding it and gaining the trust of consumers, regulators, and just people who are unfamiliar with the concept of self-driving and want to give it a try. On Las Vegas's end, on the other hand, they're really kind of taking a gamble in true Las Vegas fashion with this kind of concept, and I really hope that it pays off for them. I'm really skeptical about the throughput. Like I said, I'm really concerned about the safety when it comes to throwing lithium-ion batteries into a tunnel and hoping that they don't explode. But for the most part, I really think that the Las Vegas government is kind of propelling the future here. And what better place to do it than literally under the ground of their biggest convention center and their most popular consumer electronics show every year. So with that said, I kind of want to take a neutral stance on this kind of technology, because there's a lot of awesome aspects that I do like, futuristic, but I think there's a lot of weird and unproven and kind of snake oil-y kind of salesman-esque tactics going on here that I would think is definite farce. That said, I do think that more companies in the future are gonna give their hands at public transportation in the future, which is kind of exciting, because I don't know about you, but I'm tired about sitting around in traffic day in and day out on my commutes And I would just love to kick back in a nice, clean, self-driving Tesla or other self-driving car. So with that said, if I miss anything in this video, please let me know in the comments down below. I try to do as much research as I can, but the vagus loop and all of that technology is constantly shifting. So please let me know if I miss anything. And also, I want to know if you guys would want to ride in this crazy self-driving car. It's basically an amusement ride, right? So would you guys want to do that too? Let me know in the comments down below. Also, if you liked this video, please hit like and please subscribe to Enginomics if you want more content like this in the future. With that said, thank you so much for watching, and I'll catch you next time. Bye.